In the scope of this beginner's tutorial, I made a conscious decision to work mainly with the mouse so that every step I made could be followed visually. However, I'd still like to show a few useful key commands for working with clips. We have already learned that I can trim the clips here. By this, we are defining the start and end points of each clip. I would like to do this for this clip. In the beginning, we have this vehicle in shot. And at the end, we have yet another vehicle. And if I don't want this vehicle to appear in my clip, then I need to trim the start and end points of the clip. By using the method we know of using the mouse, I would do it so. I trim here to the new position, perhaps a little imprecise, as it is easy to slip with the mouse. But there is a small trick I'd like to show. I will find the position with the cursor, and eventually I can also use the left and right arrow keys to go frame by frame to the point I need. And now the clip end locks to the cursor position when I slide the clip end over it. Quite a useful trick for locating the clip end. And of course, this method also works for the clip start point. It is important to note that ripple mode is activated so as to avoid any following clips being left behind and hence leaving gaps. There is also a quicker method. If I have decided that I only wish to keep a clip up to a certain position, for example up to here, then I can select the clip and by using the M key on my keyboard, I can trim the clip end to the current cursor position. The active mode is taken into consideration when doing this. And with ripple mode deactivated, key M, a gap is left as the mode is taken into account. I'll undo once again. Sometimes it can be useful to have the ripple mode deactivated when working, and so I don't have to activate it each time I wish to do a trim function and have the following clips move with the edit. I have the possibility to use a trick, which is to hold the Alt key while pressing the M key. In doing so, ripple mode is activated momentarily, even though it is not active when performing other tasks. So Alt plus M trims the selected clip and automatically slides the following clips to follow the edit and not leave any gaps. This method also works for the start point. I'll undo, choose a position for the start point of my clip, it's maybe a bit too much, but this is okay for the demonstration. I'd like to start the clip from this position, and to do this I don't use the M key, but I use the N key. So I'll press the N key, and depending on the active mode, the clip's start point will be trimmed to the current cursor position. Once again, if I do this with the Alt key pressed, then the action will be performed in ripple mode. So just some tips for trimming for advanced users. It's certainly very useful to know these functions. One final remark concerning trimming. I can trim a clip's start or end point down to the accuracy of a frame by using the full stop and comma keys on my keyboard. In this case, the clip start is selected, and I can use the full stop button to move the clip start point forwards. And you can see that I can trim the clip frame by frame with the full stop to move it right, and the comma to move it to the left. Also here, it is important to note the ripple mode. As ripple mode was not active, a gap appears here. I'll undo. And if I now trim, the clips automatically follow. So, full stop and comma are useful for trimming clips frame by frame, or also to move a clip. If I don't select a clip start or end point, but select the entire clip itself, I'll turn ripple mode off, I can move the entire clip. If I use the shift button at the same time, I can move the clip in larger steps. So that's another tip for you related to the keyboard functions. Now I would like to close the gap that is left. If I choose to do this via undo, there can be a large number of steps to undo before I arrive at the correct position. It is easier in such cases to either choose the undo step that is required to close the gap from the list here, or what I can also do is something we have seen before, which is to right mouse click in the gap and to use the delete gap function. In doing so, the gap is closed. Click here for the next video. To subscribe to our YouTube channel, click here. You can find more tips and tricks in our EDIUS podcast. And this playlist contains the complete EDIUS tutorial.